Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my another learning video. So in this video we are going to talk on a candlestick pattern, or let's say it is a inside candle. So we will see how to trade with an inside candle breakout or breakdown. So we will completely see all those things. So this is live market. Now time is 11:48. So it is live market movement. You can see Nifty, Bank Nifty. Nifty, I had given this area as a resistance. You can see 11,240 to 11,260 area. I said this will act as a resistance. And today you can see, though we opened gap up, we saw a huge fall. Right, so this was about Nifty. So now we are going to talk on inside candle. So we will see a live example of inside candle also, though this example has not achieved its target. So it would be useful to you so that you can track this stock if at all it is achieving its target or not, right? So let's see. So before getting into the video, we will first see some basics, or we will understand the logic behind these trades, like how this happens. So basically we will first see the theory part, because that's most important. Also first we will understand the concept, and then we will compare it with the live chart or our chart, right? Okay, so before that, first we will see what is a candlestick pattern, or what is a candlestick. Okay, so first I would like to draw a candle. So let's say this is a candle. This is opening. Here market is open. Here a candle opens at this point, right? And from here it continuously falls. It makes a low. So this is low, let's say. And then from here it continues to move up. So this is high, and from here it continues to fall again, and then it closes somewhere around here. So this is closing price. So this is opening price, this is closing price, this is high, this is low. So now if you connect this to opening price and closing price, you will see a bar. This is called the body. This is called the body of the candle. This is called the wick or shadow of the candle. This upside also and downside also, it is called wick or the shadow. This part, this wick, right? Upside and downside. Now another important thing, will this candle be green or will it be red? That how we can know? You can see opening is upper side and closing is at lower side. So opening, it gave a good opening at upside, but closing was at low. That means the dominance of sellers are being seen here. So this candle is going to be a red candle, right? This candle's color will be red. Why? As we have seen, because opening is high and closing is below that. Okay, and vice versa. If you see a green candle, the opening will be at low and closing will be at upside. In that case, this candle will be green candle. Okay, so this candle's color will be green. So this is candlestick. So this is how candlestick is formed. Sorry, candle is formed. The color of the candle is decided this way, right? So now we will see a inside candle, how inside candle is formed. Okay, so now as of now, as we saw a candle, right? So let me just draw a candle. So let's say this is a candle. Okay, so this is a big candle, big, let's say this is a red candle. Let me just color it a bit. This is a red candle. Okay, so now it is a live market. Since I have completed my trades, so I am making this video, because today I had took a trade based on this analysis only. So that's the reason why I am sharing this video. Okay, so this is a red candle. So this is a big red candle first, This is what you have to see in a live chart. Okay, so the immediate next candle should be, okay, should be a inside candle. Now this is a candle, this is wick, this is body, and this is again a wick. So this is called inside candle, right? A big red candle and then a small inside candle. So this is called a inside candle. So now what should be the color of this candle? This can be either green, okay, or this can be either red. So basically this color doesn't matter. The color of inside candle doesn't matter. Okay, as of now we are talking about few logics. Okay, I have not made any scripts like what all do I need to talk on this video and all. So I am sharing the knowledge that comes on my mind. Okay, the knowledge that I know, I am sharing that with you all in this live market. Okay, so this color of this chart really doesn't matter. Sorry, color of this inside candle doesn't really matter. Okay, so what did we see till now? A big candle. So as of now we are talking about a breakdown candle. So for a breakdown candle, the color should be, color of the big candle should be red. Okay, no, please note all these points, it will be useful for your learning. So this should be a red, big red candle. Okay, so this is a red candle, and next candle, next inside candle, it can be red or it can be green also. It can be red or green, it doesn't really matter. So this is called a inside candle. Okay, so in this case, how we are going to take a trade, we will see that. In this case, once this low, this is the low. Okay, this is a very simple concept, but only thing is you have to wait for this pattern and then you have to trade, right? Most of the times it will look like a inside candle, but it will not a inside candle. Like let's say it will make a small wick and all, so the candle fails, the pattern fails, right? So this is the low. Once this low is broken, right? So let's say this is a live chart, this is the movement. Okay, let me just red one. So let's say this is the movement, and here it made a big red candle, and then a halt happened here, and then again there can be a halt candle also, again there can be inside candle, and then it can break down, right? So then it can give a breakdown. So this is the case of breakdown candle, inside candle breakdown. So this is how breakdown happens, right? Our entry, where will be our entry? Our entry will be this. This will be our entry. Okay, this will be our entry. Our stop loss will be above this candle, this candle's high. Our stop loss will be here. And our target, now what's the target? Target is very important. Target will be the height of the candle. Okay, this height. So mostly if you are planning for 1:1, then this height of the candle is the target. Or mostly we can also look out for 1:2, right? So if you are looking for 1:2 risk reward, then you have to keep the double of the height. You have to calculate the height of this candle, this bigger candle, right? This bigger candle, and then you have to keep measure the height from here, and then you can keep the target downside, and once the target is achieved, you can exit the trade, right? So this is about a breakdown. So vice versa, about the breakout, same thing happens, right? So now the important question is, can we trade? So this is about breakdown, right? So now the question is, can we trade if the stock breaks like this? From here, if breakout happens like this, no. Clearly, we should not trade, because that will be a risky trade. So we will avoid. So you can take trade on another setup, but as of this setup only for breakdown. You saw a red candle, right? Okay. You saw a red candle, and then you saw a inside candle. And then once the low is broken, you take a trade over here, entry, and then you will see a target. So this is about inside breakdown candle, right? This is a red candle. Now about the green candle. So after this we will also talk about the logic or the concept behind this, why this happens, right? So now we will see about the green candle. Okay, so now let's say this is a big green candle. Okay, let me just color a little bit. Okay, this is a green candle. This is about a breakout thing. This is a green candle, and then there should be a halt candle. This is inside candle. The color of this inside candle doesn't matter. Okay, let me just draw a wick also. Okay, so color of this inside candle doesn't matter. So I will just color both green and red. So this is the high of the candle. Okay, so once the breakout happens at this point, let me just take green. Okay, breakout happens at this point, this area, this high will be your entry, okay, as said, and stop loss will be below this. This should be your stop loss, and target will be, if you are planning for 1:1, the height of this candle will be your first target. You can plan for two targets also, first target, and then you can also wait for second target with a stop. You can trail your stop loss with this candle also, right? With this candle low, you can trail your, let me just write, trail stop loss, TSL. Okay, so this is, the drawing is bit bad, but this is what I can do as of now. So this is about the inside candle breakout and breakdown. So now we will see the concept behind this, right? So why there comes a fall or there comes a uptrend when this happens? Okay, so let's say market is continuously falling, or let's say market is in a side range, okay, and then there comes a big red candle. Okay, so now you all know, when does a big red candle comes? Everyone knows this very clearly. Whenever there a huge selling in market, huge selling as in some big players are selling heavily, right? With our one quantity, one lot, two lots, we are small players, we trade with small lots, so that doesn't bring a huge difference in market. But bigger players sell huge quantities, right? During such time the red candles are formed. Okay, so big players entry here, let's say this is a biggies area, BIGG, biggies, big. So this is a biggies area. So bigger players entered at this upper level only, and then after watching a fall, a huge fall, then small players come in, because they enter late only. Small players like you and I, we enter a bit late, right? So now we are entering, and with our entry there comes a small candle. Let it be red, or let it be a green. So this is the concept. I am sharing the concept why this breakout or breakdown happens, and once the breakout or breakout happens, why there again this selling pressure or buying pressure, again why does it comes in, right? So we are talking about this. So here we all are entering. So let's say most of the people, what we think, after a huge fall, right, after a huge fall, what do we think? Market will reverse from here, right? This is what our expectation is. Most of the retailers think like this, and that's why they take trade against the trend, and that's why here these inside candles are formed, right? So here small players, let's say there are some people are selling, or some people are even buying the stock or index, but the important point is, now those who have bought here after a huge fall, those who have bought at here, and let's say price is again, let me just clear this. Okay, so let's say price is again falling from here, price is again started to fall and touches this area, touches the low of the previous candle. Okay, so let's say here people are bullish, people are buying at this area, right? People are buying at this area, and then thinking, because here one thing, why people, most of the people buy here, because here stop loss is very small, right? If you buy at this area, you have to keep a stop loss of only below this level. So most of the people, small players, usually prefer buying at this area, so they buy. But once this low is broken, so let's say I have bought here 100 quantity and kept my stop loss at this area, right? So what is a stop loss order? Stop loss order is basically a sell order, right? Once you are buying, so once you have went long, then stop loss order is your sell order, right? So here I had bought 100 quantities, and once the market is, let me just take another color. So once market is reversing and this area is hit, so my stop loss is hit, and I will also become a seller. I will also become a seller because my order will become a sell order. So what I am doing? I am selling the stock. I was long, now I am selling the same stock, and now I am a seller, right? So one point, the biggest sellers are selling. Second, now the retailers or the small players have also become a seller. So that comes brings in a selling pressure at this area, and then again the stock fails and it gives a low side target, right? So this is the concept. And same way, the upside also same thing happens. So let me just quickly explain it all so that you can it will be very easy for you all. So this is a green candle, let's say. Okay, this is a green candle. Bigger people are buying at this area, right? After a certain point, small players come in this area. Here the candle is green or red, anything that will not matter. Small players like you and I are coming in this area. We are selling this. Why? We have kept a stop loss here, a small stop loss. And then once this is broken, we are now short sellers. We have sold, right? And once this is broken again, once this area is broken again, right, then I will become a buyer, right? Because if you are short, then your stop loss order will be a buy order. So two points here also. Bigger players are in long, and then smaller players like you and I are also long. Now once our stop loss is hit, we will also go long. Then of course this momentum is worthy. So after all this inside candle breakout, we will see a huge momentum again upside, right? So this is the concept behind the trade. This is the easiest concept, and we will usually find this this pattern are mostly found in index and stocks. We can find this everywhere. So this is the concept. So quickly let us go to our chart now, today's chart. So let's see, where are we trading? We are here. Okay, because this is a live market, and Havells again, it is going upside only. You can see Havells. We will see this in our Havells. I had already shared Havells in my weekly analysis video, so I hope it would have been useful for you all. Okay, so Havells gave a good dip today and then a movement, right? So good money in Havells, because Havells open here, like it gave a good dip of 7 to 8 points, and then it is now trading above today's high. Okay, so what is the concept in Havells? Havells, where did I see a inside candle? Okay, let me just zoom in. Let me just take brush. Okay, now you can see a big red green candle here. This area is a green candle. As we said, if you are going long, if you are planning to enter into a long side, then this should be a green candle, right? And then inside candle should be at upside, not downside. Inside candle should be formed at upside area. Okay, so this is a perfect inside candle. So I had shared this chart with my premium members who had opened account under me in Asta, and we all trade together in that channel. So I had shared this analysis, so everyone would have booked. We took a trade in future. Actually it was a positional trade, So, but intraday also we got around 5 points here. Okay, 5 points, lot size is 1,000. So the profit amount becomes 5,000 per lot, right? And Asta gives huge margin money for that. So everyone would have taken trade based on that. Okay, so as of us, what I had taught, once this is broken, this high, we will enter, right? Once this high is broken, we will enter. So now how to keep the stop loss? Stop loss, what did I say? Below the low of the candle, this will be our stop loss. Let me just write it over here. Stop loss. I'm writing because it will be useful for you all. So this low is the stop loss, and here it is the entry. Entry, where can I write? I will write here. Okay, this is the entry, let's say, as this area. Now, how to keep target if you are planning for 1:1? Let's say, calculate this area from here to this. This is approx, let's say, 6.85, or let's say it's a 7 point from here. So from this area, you have to keep same 7 points. Okay. If you keep 7 points, 6.95, then your target area is this. Okay, for 1:1. Okay, so it is not yet achieved. So I totally believe that it will achieve without hitting stop loss. But you can see the setup, any setup or any strategy, it has only 60 to 70%, or let's say below 50% only. All strategies work that way only. No strategy is 100% working. Doesn't no strategies work 100%, right? So that's why we keep stop loss. Okay, it can fail also, but that's what market is. So this would be the first target. Let me just write it over here. This will be your first target if you are planning for 1:1, this area. And then if you are planning for 1:2, then from here it was 7 point, right? Then 17 point, sorry, 14 point, somewhere around this area will be your second target. That is 627 level. So this will be your second target as of the inside candle pattern. Right? So this is the second target. So this is how inside candle trading happens. So this is how we trade inside candle, right? So I hope you have understood the concept. It is a simple and simple concept. And to take trade based on inside candle, please always take, let's say, take 15 minutes. It would be more appropriate. You can also take 5 minutes, but in 5 minutes there would be a lot of entry, so there can be some confusions also. So usually prefer 15 minutes, so it will be useful for you all. So now it is trading around 615. Our entry is 613. Still, and our stop loss is 605, let's say. So always consider the resistance area also. So this is a resistance area, resistance and support area also. So we should, whatever trade we take, never forget the resistance and support, right? So that would be very useful for you all. So if you all keep searching, so if you all want to learn something, then go back to previous charts and all. Keep do search some similar stocks or a similar pattern in Nifty, Bank Nifty, anything. You will find a huge lot of patterns over here in Nifty also. It will be beneficial for you all. It will be helpful for you all, right? So if you see here in Nifty also, let me just share here, an inside candle was formed, but it is a upside breakout. So in this case we don't trade, right? As we shared, this breakout should be a downside. This should be a breakdown. If this would have broken, then there could be some profit again, right? So likewise, you can go and find some stocks. It will be helpful for you all. Here you can see right here, this area, a inside candle. This is a inside candle, and let's say this was the stop loss. So there is a two type of people who keep stop loss here. So smaller player keeps stop loss above this area. This area can also act as a stop loss level. So if you see here, so let's see the target. I don't think target is achieved in this, because it has hit the stop loss, the low, you can see. Okay, so from here the level is 55 points, and from here once the breakdown has happened, so here it is only 28 points, right? So here the target didn't achieve if you had kept the stop loss at this level, at this upside level. Okay, but if you had kept stop loss above this level, right, you can keep that also. Let me just show you how to do that. Okay, usually in intraday basis, because we trade in a small momentum, so we can keep stop loss for that also. Like let's say this is a big candle, and then this is a inside candle, right? And then this can be our stop loss also. If you are a bigger player, then you can keep stop loss above this. But if you are a smaller player, you can keep stop loss above this smaller inside candle, and then calculate the length of this smaller candle, and then you can keep target. So in that case, mostly we don't hit our stop loss, because it is a small candle, we usually end up in profit. So let's say this was our target, which was 17 point. Okay, so it has clearly achieved. If you see at this, it is 28 point. So it has clearly achieved. So likewise, there is a lot of candlestick patterns you can find. So but you have to be very careful with it. You have to check how it is formed and all. So where you have to place the stop loss and all. But at this area in Havells, we have kept a bigger stop loss, because I am expecting a bigger profit. I am expecting this level, which is 621 or 622, it can break the level, right? I am expecting it to be broken in few sessions. So that's the reason why I had kept that stop loss, right? So I hope this video was informative for you all. I hope you have been noting down few points from here, and you have been learning few things and all. So if you see Bajaj Finance were also given in my YouTube channel analysis video of a weekly. So I had said that this area will act as a support. This area can act as support. Which area? Let me just draw it for you all. This area, it will act as a support, and I had took my positions accordingly here at this point only, because it's a green candle as of now. So even if it falls, that I am not going to exit it, because I can see a trend line over here. So Bajaj Finance can go positive from here. It can go. Another thing is, Bajaj Finance can also give a smaller breakout also. You can see this can also give a breakout. So keep watching Bajaj Finance, and good profit can be seen in Bajaj Finance, because it is in a range. I have shared this in Bajaj Finance also in my weekly. So it can break the range also. So I hope you have been learning something out of this video. So this is live market, so it was a very interesting thing. So as you can see this candle, let me just share one more thing. You can see this candle, green candle. When I was making a video, it was falling and it was making a red candle. So most of the people get scared by that. You can see the fall was of only of 6, from 618 to 616, only 2 points. But by seeing such red candles, people get scared and they immediately exit the trade, right? So that doesn't happen like that. You should not trade based on emotions. You should be trading with proper technical analysis, right? So once we entered, I am waiting with stop loss. So I hope I will book some good profit in Havells. So that's it for the day. I hope this video was useful for you all. So meet you all with some another analysis video or another interesting learning video. So if at all this video was useful for you all, please but do some homework, do some research, and don't take trades, any trade based on my analysis, and do some own research also. So go sit on a laptop, sit on a mobile, or search for inside candles, breakout or breakdown, and check backtest it, how many times it has hit the stop loss, or how many times it has hit the target, where can we keep the target, or where can we keep the stop loss. Such things, do some backtest from here, and then you take a trade based on that, right? So Nifty, as I had said, Nifty can be in this range. On my weekly analysis video, I said Nifty can trade in this range only, and as of now Nifty is still trading in this range, so that's a good thing. So it is all a simple analysis, but only thing is you have to sit with proper discipline, and you have to give time for learning, right? Don't just trade with others tips and all. If at all you are trading with my calls also, you have to do your own analysis, you have to sit and back test it, you have to check everything, right? So guys, that's it for the day. Hope this video was useful for you all. So meet you all with some another learning content. So until then, have a profitable trading sessions with you all. So thank you for watching.